Hello viewers, you were waiting for my latest video about Japanese new immigration policy which Japanese government announced last year. So here I am with the latest news and update and information, and time to time I bring the information to keep you update, not to misguide you. And whatever the information I get is from the valid source. So I already mentioned in my previous video that Japanese government last year introduced new immigration visa policy for foreign blue collar workers, and there was a reason for hiring these foreign workers from Asian countries, and the reason was the Japan aging population, low birth rate, and labor shortage, and industrial growth also. So to meet this challenge, Japan government introduced new immigration visa policy, and so far as they mentioned that Japan government are making negotiation with and making framework with some Asian countries which I already mentioned, for example Thailand, Myanmar, China, Cambodia, Vietnam, Philippines, Indonesia, and recently one more country is added, that is Mongolia. Mongolia is recently added in this list. Earlier there were only 8 countries, now it become 9 countries. So far 9 countries are eligible. The workers from these 9 countries are eligible to apply for work visa. So far workers from India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka are not eligible. Maybe on the last moment or April, maybe they include or not, it is not confirmed. So far only these 9 countries are eligible, and Japanese government is making government to government negotiation framework and procedure, and the framework is being made because this April they will start issuing work permit to these foreign blue collar workers and highly skilled workers. So already there are many Asians worker already there, and they are trainees in Japan. And recently the Japan government warned these trainees because now there is a information that Japan already introduced new visa policy, and these trainees are maybe thinking that they must switch off to other companies. So Japan government warned to these trainees. Many intern trainees from Vietnam, Cambodia, Thailand, Myanmar, Indonesia, Philippines, Nepal and China are working in Japan. It is warned by Japanese government to all trainees that not to change jobs illegally or risk being arrested. Some trainees had fled or planning from their workplace to find other jobs illegally. Most of them were misled by brokers or friends to work somewhere paying higher wages. Maybe some they misguide their friends or some brokers. Japanese immigration authority on Monday stopped issuing labor cards to trainees who had left their old workplaces if their visa had expired when they escape from their old workplaces. They will face arrest by Japanese authorities for overstaying their visa. The government is considering conducting tests in these 9 countries to bring farm workers into Japan under a new working visa category, planned to be introduced in April. There were many foreign trainees in Japan, and 99% of them were from the 7 countries of, for example, Vietnam, China, the Philippines, Indonesia, Thailand, Cambodia, Myanmar. The government therefore expect many from those countries to apply for the new working visa. The government may afterward narrow down the list of countries where the test will be held after consulting with each country's respective government. The tests are planned to be held in the country's native language and will cover the 2 fields of farming, plants and animals. The government estimates that up to 7,300 foreign nationals will work in Japan's agriculture sector in the first year of the new visa system, and that up to 36,500 foreign workers will do so in the first 5 years. The government plans to limit the eligibility for type 1 visas to workers in 14 industries, which I told you earlier, which can include the farming sector. The government is also considering holding tests overseas for type 1 visa for construction, fishery and other sectors. The other types do not have educational background requirement at this point, but that reaching a certain proficiency of Japanese language is expected to be mandatory, along with other relevant tests to check applicants' skill for the occupation in which they intend to work. So I do hope that you already preparing learning the new language, Japanese language, and I told you that start learning Japanese, at least some basic phrases, words, because it will help you for shortlisting among many candidates who don't have any knowledge about Japanese language. So if you didn't start so far, please start now. Start learning Japanese language, and especially if you are applying in the nursing and caregivers category, it is mandatory. So you must have a Japanese language proficiency level N1 and N2. Minimum is N2 is acceptable. So other categories also, it is mandatory, but for nursing and caregivers category is N2 Japanese language proficiency test is required. So that's why I'm every time focus to learning about Japanese language. So if you are really interested to go to Japan or planning in the next year or next few years, so act now, start learning, because it will help you most, because it will shortlist you, you will be welcome and you will have more job opportunities in Japan, because in Japan Japanese people are not much fluent in Japan English language, so it will help you to easily assimilate in that culture, understand, and very immediate you will be productive and that's why they will hire you. So I do hope that you like this information which I shared with you, and please do comment, like, and please do subscribe my channel for more updated videos. Thank you and stay connected. Thanks.